I was home. The reason I was home because I had to go to a funeral, and the funeral was for one of my best friends, and it really hit me really, really hard, because I'm used to old people dying, and I'm not used to young people dying, and that I know. And I was on a plane, and I was trying to be strong, and I started crying on an airplane, and I was a little disappointed in myself, because I was crying in public. And this lady sitting next to me, she was a sweet old lady, and she's like, "Are you all right?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I'll be fine. I'm just going home for a funeral. My friend passed away." And she's like, "Oh, I'm so sorry. Where's home?" And I was like, I'm from Detroit. And she says, "Oh, I'm so sorry your friend got shot." She assumed, because I was going home to Detroit, that my friend got shot. Like, lady, like, you just, what is wrong with you, lady? I mean, my friend did get shot. Like, I know that. But you gotta let me tell you, and I know, I'm not crazy. I know if we were playing Family Feud right now, and it was like, "How do you die in Detroit?" Like, "Get shot, Steve." And they're like, "On the board, number two answer, get shot. Number one answer, get shot multiple times." But she gotta just let me tell her that. She can't assume. So I go home to my friend's funeral, and I really don't like funerals because, like, if you're dead, you have no say in it. You have no say in all. They can do whatever they want to do. Like they put my friend in a suit. Like, he would never wear a suit. He didn't even own a suit. They had to buy a suit for him for his funeral. Like, I have a rule, like, if you have to buy a suit for your funeral, don't bury him in a suit, okay? And if I die, just bury me naked. But yeah, I didn't like that. And then I saw his mom, and I hadn't seen his mom in a while. And I was like, "Hey, you know what? I just want to send you my condolences for your loss." And she said, "Thank you." And then she looked me in my face, and she was like, "Oh, wow. You've put on some weight since I seen you last." She said, "I put on some weight since I seen you last." Like, here I am giving her condolences for her loss, and she's giving them right back to me for my game. Like, that's wrong. Like, she should be able to do that, man. Like, because I couldn't walk to her and be like, "Man, Miss Burton, you look old as fuck. I used to want to have sex with you." Like, I couldn't do that, because that's not right. I can't do that. I can't. She just tells me whatever. I'm like, "Miss Burton, you don't know. I've been putting on weight on purpose. I've been putting on weight for this movie, guys. Yes, I've been putting on weight for this movie that I'm just gonna watch. I'm just watching this movie. It's called The Legend of Bagger Vance. I don't know if you guys heard about it. Yeah, I'm just eating a lot of popcorn to see what movie Will Smith turned down The Matrix for. That is, he didn't want to be Neo, he wanted to be Matt Damon's caddy. That's, he did, that's the truth. He turned it down. Yeah, that's the true story. I'm writing the movie though, because in LA you have to have like 80 different jobs. So I'm writing this movie, and it's a period piece. I'm writing a period piece. So this movie that I'm writing is a period piece, and it's called Thank God It Came. Because it's a period piece. And it's called Thank God It Came. That joke is like a wave. And the tagline for the movie is, "In a world where everyone hates their period until they don't have one, coming this January." I don't know. Hopefully it's coming. Hopefully. It's a little menstruation joke. Yes. Clap it up for menstruation. Telling women are not pregnant for, like, since the beginning of time.